Now let's export our project from Adobe Premiere Pro for WhatsApp. So these are the steps involved. Let's go into the detail of each step. Keeping the timeline open, I go to File, Export, Media. It opens the Export Settings dialog box. I select the format as H.264. And once I select H.264 as my format, I get a lot of presets. To export my video for WhatsApp, I would choose the preset Match Source High Bitrate. So now I scroll down in the video settings to bitrate settings. So for the best results, I choose VBR 2-pass. And I will have a look at the estimated file size. As you decrease the target bitrate, the quality of the video degrades and the file size also decreases. And as you increase the target bitrate, the quality of the export increases as well as the file size. So it's a trade-off between quality and file size. As per the current specifications of WhatsApp, the file size should not be more than 64 MB and 16 MB for the mobile application. So I adjust the target bitrate slider to make sure that the file size is just below 64 MB. At 0.44 Mbps, it gives me 64 MB. It means the file size is between 64 MB and 65 MB. At 0.43 Mbps, it's giving me 63 MB, which is less than 64 MB. So now I copy the target bitrate value to the maximum bitrate. So now I scroll up to the basic video settings. This is the width and height of your video frame. So now most of the smartphones and most of the displays supports Full HD. I would prefer keeping the video dimensions Full HD. If your video bitrate is really low, I recommend keeping the dimensions by half. Now I go to my audio settings. So you know, any audio is a wave. So in the digital world, a wave is stored as samples, which are sampled at discrete intervals of time. So if I keep my sampling rate at 48,000, it samples the audio 48,000 times every second. The human audible frequency ranges between 20 to 20,000 Hertz. The maximum frequency a human ear can hear is 20,000. As per Nyquist sampling theory, if you sample an audio at a frequency above 40,000, it can store all that human beings can hear. So, 44.1 kHz or 48 kHz will have a good room to store all that a human ear can hear. So, coming down to channels, if your audio is mono, you can keep mono. And if your audio is stereo, keep stereo. The audio quality defines the algorithm in which Adobe Premiere Pro encodes your audio. So if you keep high, the audio quality will be better, but it takes more time to encode. So now coming to the most important factor, the bitrate. This is the amount of bits allotted to store your audio every second. So if I select 160 kbps as audio bitrate, it will use 160 kilobits per second to store the audio information. If I keep stereo in my channel, the audio bitrate will be split between the left and the right channels. As I increase the audio bitrate, the quality of the audio increases. The file size also increases. And as I decrease the bitrate, the quality of the audio decreases. The file size decreases. But most consumer headphones and speakers can produce only very limited frequencies. So because of that, you won't be able to easily identify the difference between a higher bitrate audio and a lower bitrate audio. So I would prefer decreasing my audio bitrate a little bit and giving that extra room to the video so I can get better video quality, because video requires much more bandwidth than audio. So now there are two factors which governs the file size, the audio bitrate and the video bitrate. So once this is done, I give my file name and export my video. So now here is my exported file. So when I check the file size of my export, it says 66.8 MB. I was expecting 64. What happened? So it says the file size is 667,50,195 bytes. So this is more than 64 MB, right? This is because there are two scales to measure the quantity of data. One is a technical scale and the other one is a commercial scale. So in the technical scale, 1024 or 2 to the power 10 bytes make 1 kilobyte. And in the commercial scale, 1000 bytes make 1 kilobyte. My Mac uses a commercial measurement, so it just divided by thousands to show me the file size as 66.8 MB. To convert this into technical file size, I open calculator, I divide the file size by 1024. This is the file size in kilobytes. So now I again divide it by 1024. So it gives me 63.65, which is the technical file size of my file. And this is less than 64 MB. And I can send this by WhatsApp. So here is a tip. So wondering how to make custom thumbnail for your WhatsApp videos? Keep your thumbnail image as a first frame on your timeline. So hope you guys understood how to make an export for WhatsApp from Adobe Premiere Pro. And see you next time.